here for another episode of Luminescence, and I have the great honor of being here with Adama today, who is someone that I have been tuning into on WRFG in Atlanta for years and years and years, someone that I really admire, someone that is a great leader in our community. Adama, she is known as the heraldess of the eternal, the voice of resurrection. And we're here in her gorgeous space. It's called Mother Earth's Blessing, Wholistic Life Center. And it's on Cheshire Bridge on 1830 Cheshire Bridge Road in Atlanta. And it's a gorgeous space here. Adama is the host of Adama Speaks, the meeting of the inner circle on Night Watch on WRFG. And
89.3
FM in Atlanta. And if you're not in Atlanta, you can still go to WRFG.org and stream live on Thursday nights from midnight to 3 a.m.
Mm-hmm. And then others who would prefer radio apps and their phones.
Okay.
They can download. And go to WRFG.
So I feel like, can I just tell a little personal that My personal, so we just recently ran into each other again at a Kwanzaa event at Wadada, mm-hmm. which is a juice bar in the historic West End, and Adama was a featured speaker, and I was just, we hadn't seen each other in probably a few years or longer,
many years. Right.
And I was reminded of how powerful you are and what an important message you have for us during this time when we're birthing the new earth and in need of leadership like yours and a voice like yours. And I remember when I moved to Atlanta about 20 years ago, and at that time I had just become a raw foodist, and I had just gotten attuned to Reiki, and I was in my 20s. And I remember tuning the radio to WRFG, and I was like, okay, wait a second, who is this woman? She's channeling all, oh, plus I have a sociology degree, so I've like studied all about society and capitalism, patriarchy, blah, blah, blah. So I'm like already like into all this stuff, and I tuned into your show, and I'm just like, okay, who is this woman? Because she's talking about raw food, she's talking about cleansing, she's talking about the colon, she's talking about like society, and she's talking about all these things, and it's like 2 a.m. right now. Like, I was so taken aback by you and just so amazed. Like, I have a deep respect. So I'm grateful to be here.
Thank you. Thank you for caring to be present with us. Everybody don't care. So those who do show up, I'm so grateful and so honored. You know, the now moment in which we're in is requiring us to realize that there is no salvation or deliverance or success that we can have as long as we have greater and greater numbers of those who are sick and ill and diseased and dying.
Mm.
There's been very little progression where we are having greater and greater numbers of children who are being diagnosed with all manners of sickness, illness, disease, and dying.
Mm.
And so I have been speaking on radio with WRFG, and even before I got to the radio, I was in service, really serving some of the best vegetarian food you could get at the time from 1994 to 1999, a little 5 points with Mother Earth's adornments for the whole being, body, heart, mind, soul, and more. So my intention has always been to really serve in our liberation, our salvation, to realize that I realized in college, once I became aware at the University of Florida in the mid-70s, that there was an initiative called Global 2000 to eliminate over 3.5 billion people from the face of the earth by the year 2000. So the pandemic that we've already been under in terms of the abortions, the heart disease, the cancer, the diabetes, the obesity, the strokes, the aneurysms, the blindness, the suicide, the, you know, the spouse abuse, the rape, the violation. You understand that this is not God's way. But there aren't any ones who've come to the earth from whatever other realm they've come to the earth through the wounds of perpetuators of sickness, illness, disease, and death as livelihood.
Mm.
You understand? So where you have multi and where we are impacted and affected by initiative that has become multi-trillion dollar industry and business in sickness, illness, disease, and death,
mm.
we can't participate and think that there's any real success that you can have in life.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so the conversation that I've been bringing to the airwaves for 21 years is how do we respond correctly and directly to being under a global initiative of depopulation and genocide?
Mm.
All right, so now people are seeing the pushing of the envelope in this COVIDiacy that's going on to the degree to which now people are saying, okay, well, Adama's been speaking to this for a long time, but the issue is that how is it that very few people were addressing the reality that we were already in pandemic? We were already in crisis. We were already in a state of emergency as a global family, and then there was no real proper response globally. All right, so now everybody's responding or reacting and participating with something that isn't as real as the cancer, the heart disease, the diabetes, the strokes, the all of that, which now is being lumped under COVID.
Right.
So it matters that we, the wound man, who really should be always committed to the nourishing, the nurturing, the facilitating, the uplifting, the standing on behalf of life, there are no ones of us who can be licensed, certified, and degreed to be the perpetuators of sickness, illness, and disease as livelihood, and then think that there's some success that we can have in life.
Mm. Mm.
And on behalf of the lineages that we represent, and it doesn't matter what hue of people we are, from the blackest black to the lightest light, nobody has been sent to the earth to be the perpetuators of sickness, illness, disease, and death as livelihood.
Mm.
That ain't God.
Mm.
And so where we are right now is calling us to the responsibility to be able and to be caring to be able to respond correctly and directly in our now moment.
Mm.
You understand? Our now moment is a little different from our mothers and our fathers and our grandmothers and our grandfathers and our great-grandmothers and our great-grandfathers, even though they were all somehow impacted and affected by an initiative to oppress us at our cellular functioning through giving us the flesh of dead animals, the aborted feces of chickens, the pus and mucus of cows, artificial colors, artificial flavors, NutraSweet, aspartame, white sugar, and the alcohol and tobacco, and now the pharmaceuticals, and these things I refer to as the weapons of mass destruction. So how really can people really take this thing seriously when tobacco and alcohol have destroyed more lives and more livers and more families than all of the wars that these people have engaged in, these people being the United States government.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So how can we think that what we're seeing now is actual pandemic when we have been dying in greater and greater numbers and it's affected all of our families?
Mm-hmm.
So the issue for us and the issue that I bring forward is that women, the wound man, wherever we are, if you've been diagnosed with anything, you understand, from AIDS to zits, it's now our time to understand that being vegan and vegetarian is not sufficient. Changing the diet is not sufficient.
Mm.
Because I've seen over the 40-some years that I've been in this community, vegans and vegetarians pass away with breast cancer, uterine cancer, cervical cancer, ovarian cancer, and prostate cancer, and other issues.
Mm.
Because the chemicals, the pesticides, the herbicides, the antibiotics, the hormones, the BHA, the BHT, the shelf stabilizers, and all of the things that make our orange juice taste the same, whether we get it in Florida, or whether we get it in Washington State, or whether we get it in upstate New York, it all tastes the same, and we don't think that that's chemical.
Mm.
And so the effect of the chemicals is that they have modified our behavior to the degree to which we are not able, and we have not been responding correctly and directly to being under siege and being warred against.
Mm. Mm.
So the years ago, from the 40s, 50s, dealing with Jim Crow and all of that, you know, Europeans didn't think that it was them. They just thought it was us, and they felt some degree of entitlement. because it was just us. And it wasn't until they really realized when they were outsourcing all of the jobs to Indonesia and India and all these places, when they start losing their $60,000 salaries and whatnot, that people begin to realize that this is a, it's an all people war.
Mm.
Everybody's being warred against. It's not a black and white issue.
Mm.
It's an intelligence issue.
Mm.
Mother Earth, Mother Nature, and all of her creatures. We are facilitating the murder of billions of animals on an annual basis as if their lives don't matter.
Mm.
And as these points of an absolute and supreme intelligence, I'm here to say all of our lives matter because life is the gift.
Mm.
And we will never work for, beg, borrow, steal, be awarded or rewarded anything that is greater than who and what we already are but naked. There is no amount of money that has ever been printed, regardless of how fine the paper or the ink, no matter whose image is upon it, no amount of coinage that has ever been minted, no matter what the metal from which it was formed in the image and what country it represents, none of it is as great as one beat of our heart or one breath that we take.
Mm.
But it's hard to feel the worthiness, it's hard to feel the deservedness, it's hard to really feel how blessed we each are with each and every breath and every beat of our heart. When the blood is defiled with the violation of violated beings, when our blood burns hot with the rot of pigs and cows and turkeys and chicken and alcohol and tobacco and marijuana and Hennessy and all of this stuff, I'm just saying, a nation that has established itself on the marginalization and the disenfranchisement and the murder and slaughter of our indigenous families, built itself up on the enslavement of our African families, and then worked towards the oppression of everything and everybody else, is a place and nation that has already fallen.
Mm.
It's already fallen.
Mm.
And so what we're having the opportunity to do is to remember that we are these points of an absolute and supreme intelligence that is beginningless, endless, infinite, and eternal. It is beating our hearts and it breathes us. And it has gifted itself to each of us. From the blackest black to the lightest light, and everything that creeps and crawls and flies and has its being, everything is intelligence of existence. And there are no ones who have been licensed, certified, and degreed by the intelligence of existence to kill it.
Mm.
To undermine it, to enslave it, to capture it,
mm.
to desecrate, defile, subjugate it, and bastardize it, to render it useless and dysfunctional. So where we are now is requiring us to realize that we must rise. That death should not be and was never intended to be the culmination, the eventuality, the destiny, or the fate of what it is to be. Because the earth is as big as a period at the end of a sentence in relationship to the rest of all of that that is cosmic. We are already in the realm of eternity.
Mm.
We should not be dying at all.
Mm.
So the trick here has been to disqualify the divinity of being. To say, oh, well, you know, as humans, we were born in sin, and we will always be sinned and sin-filled, and our nature is sinful.
Hmm.
But our nature is not sinful. We've been poisoned all of our lives.
Hmm.
The breakfast cereals, the hot dogs, the hamburgers, the fish, the Vienna sausage, the Spam, the chitlins, all of this stuff that people have eaten all over this country and all over the world in terms of monkey brains and penis, yaks of penises and all of these things, the liver and the kidneys, and we can't feed off the flesh of dead animals when we were told not to kill. The killing has now become game and sport. There has to be something amidst with ones and ones who feel power when they watch and they facilitate the draining of one's life for it. Whether it's the foot on the neck or whether it's the blood coming from them. I'm just saying that we're dealing with the reality of being in a death culture. so the healing begins with our realigning with the divinity of existence itself. Our healing begins when we accept that every eye that sees, sees as an eye of God. That we may not know the purposes for all of these beings, but they're not here just for our amusement.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So as wombed men who've been licensed and certified and degreed to be black and white faced behind idiocy and stupidity in feeling some entitlement in suppressing, oppressing, dumbing down, anesthetizing, inebriating, intoxicating, and stupefying other ones.
Hmm.
There's no supremacy in stupidity. There's absolute law that governs our lives. And the fulfillment of the law is love. But if we can't love ourselves to the degree to which we will facilitate cellular liberation, in realizing that it's not about just being vegan and vegetarian, we're all breatharian first.
Hmm.
We have to breathe. It is the breath that is the animating, maintaining, sustaining force of our being, of our lives. We're 80% water, like the earth is 80% water. So feeding off the flesh and blood of other beings can't do anything but ensure a tragic date with fate. So now we're having to take the time to come to a place where we are consciously caring to respond correctly and directly in our now moment by ceasing and desisting from feeding ourselves, our children, and our loved ones the flesh of dead animals, the aborted feces of chickens, the pus and mucus of cows, all matters of artificial colors and flavors and all of that stuff that is creating all of this paste and gook and mucus. So by the time when I was a little girl, the teacher would say, tell your mom to send 2 cups of flour to school. We're going to do art. Take the 2 cups of flour, we mix it with water, and we do our paper mache because it makes paste.
Right.
So the cakes, the cookies, the breads, the biscuits, the pancakes, the waffles, the donuts, the croissants, the scones, all of these things are flour and water. That's why people are sick.
Mm-hmm.
So we're talking asthma, pneumonia, bronchitis, allergies. You understand? So we, as wombed men and as men without the womb, are the perpetuators of life. We are the progenitor and the perpetuator of lineages of people. And whether we have and bring forth children through our own wombs and loins or not, everybody is here to exalt life, to rejoice in the blessedness of being, to really unfold in their creativity, their ingenuity, their uniqueness, their divine assignment to walk the face of this earth on behalf of life itself, to the detriment of nothing and no one for any reason at any time. And so, exalting a full effort in our living, that's what all intelligences do. Whether it was the squirrel who was eating the avocado from the compost the other day, he was so happy. He was like really happy. I was like, oh, why is he eating? He's like really happy. I was like, I need to throw some more out there for you. You know, so, but the intelligences of existence, we exalt a full effort in our living. Whether it's the rat, the cat, the bread creatures are still intelligent. They're still completely intelligent. Right? The nature of intelligence is going to exalt a full effort in its living. It does nothing to undermine itself. It knows its food, it excretes its waste, it knows its kind, it perpetuates itself, and it will respond correctly and directly when it senses that its life is being threatened. How do we know our behavior has been modified? Is that we feel entitled to undermine ourselves. We feel entitled to be smoking and drinking and getting high, and even though we're vegan, the issue is that the accumulation, the saturation, and the contraindication of the preservatives, the antibiotics, the hormones, the residues that were in the flesh of the fish and the cows and the chickens, and all of that is now in the brain. It's in the pineal gland, it's in the organs, it's in the womb. fibroids, it's the tumors, it's the cancer. So the responsibility that we have now is to consciously care, to be completely cleared, cleared of the pain, the disdain, the unworthiness, the trepidation, the fear, the sense of sinfulness that comes as a result of being raped and violated and trespassed and incest and all of that from the time that we were youth.
Mm.
You understand, the abortions and certain things that we're holding on to, we're not forgiving. We've
mm-hmm.
got to let go. We've got to come to a point and place where we care to be liberated
mm-hmm.
from all of that.
Mm.
You understand, so that's why I'm promoting myself as the voice of our resurrection, because one, we are already these points of an absolute and supreme intelligence that is beginning us in this infinite and eternal. We should not be dying at all.
Mm-hmm.
And so stepping off that path of adulteration onto the path of maturation, coming to a point where we realize that breath is the high, living is the high. We don't have to get high, we need to be in the height of the truth of ourselves. We were told to know the truth, and the truth would make us free.
Mm-hmm.
And so coming to this place and space where we are oxygenating, hydrating, mineralizing, and opening up all channels of elimination,
mm-hmm.
and realizing that food is not just a choice. There is that which our cells really require in order to function optimally.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when our bodies have been filled with so much of the mucus and the flesh and the acidity and the parasites and the worms and the organisms and whatnot, then we've got to be aggressive about cleansing.
Right.
The herbs, fresh fruit in the mornings, juicy fruit, not just bananas and avocados. We have to learn how to just really partake of the blessedness of being. We have to learn how to forgive and let go and release and cleanse ourselves. So we brush our teeth every day, and then we bury the outside of the body, but then we spend the rest of the time putting junk in the trunk. And the trunk is like, ooh, it's like, ooh, it's like, yeah, ooh, it's like, you know what I'm saying? But it's completely reversible.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we established Mother Earth's Blessing Holistic Life Center, so that we create the initiative for using the earth, using the clay, which is magnetic. Most of us grew up, we played on the dirt, we ate the dirt, we made mud pies, we laid on the earth, even in the snow, we were doing angels, and we sun gazed, and we did all of these things as children. We had so much sense, we were barefoot.
Mm-hmm.
We had a dynamic relationship with
mm-hmm.
Mother Earth. Now we're bringing Mother Earth into the system to pull anything that's inorganic out of our tissues.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people are just changing the diet. Changing the diet does not facilitate getting the chemicals out of the brain.
Mm.
So the body is trying to protect itself. So when you stop eating all of the stuff that we grew up eating, and then go to fruit and vegetation, but then they're doing buckwheat pancakes or whole wheat pancakes instead of white flour and Jemima pancakes, or they're doing scrambled tofu as opposed to doing scrambled eggs, or a vegan form of the stuff that we grew up with will continue to create more sickness in our communities.
Mm. Mm. Yeah.
And a lot of people are not addressing the cleansing
mm-hmm.
that should be daily. They're doing 10-day detoxes, 40-day detoxes, a 30-day fast. And I'm saying, but for 30, 40 years, you ate all of this stuff. So no, it's about getting intensely intentional on walking in the integrity of the divinity of our being, realizing that these bodies are to be purified for the consecration and the re-enthronement of the true spirits of the living gods and goddesses that we are.
Mm-hmm.
It is not rhetoric. People are rhetoricizing and philosophizing and theorizing and all of that when their bodies are full of the rot, the decay, the decomposition of all of this stuff.
Mm.
People can get licensed as Reiki masters after 2 or 3 days and be 300 pounds. So I'm just saying is that our love for ourselves and ourselves has to come first.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's no change that we can make in a society if we do not take time to change the lymphatic system and
mm.
bloodstream that bears no violation of violated beings, no inebriants, no intoxicants, no behavior modifying chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
How do we know our behavior has been modified? Because we're serving flesh and death to our children.
Mm-hmm.
We feel entitled. We feel as though we were given the free will to be wrong, the right to be wrong.
Mm.
And so our now moment is pregnant with opportunity, because there's so much that we have to do to us.
Mm-hmm.
And if the food has to get so bad that we can't eat it, then we'll really get a chance to see what we're made out of.
Uh-huh.
As spirits,
yes,
who are breathing beings.
Yes.
I know, I know. You have questions?
No, it's okay. I mean, it's like you are... I want to say you're a channel, but you're not really. I mean, you're just speaking. You're just you. You're just speaking. It's so beautiful. So I love to listen.
Oh, very good. Well, I'm really like wanting us to realize that, particularly for the women who have organizations, the women who have daycare, the women who are feeding the homeless and the helpless, the women who are working with juveniles, the women who have their own businesses and whatnot, but then still have high blood pressure, still overweight. So the center was created so that we are able to support us in loving ourselves and regaining our stature as the true healers.
Yes. Yes, it's a beautiful center. It's community space over here. There's little healing rooms, and gosh, I just... Everything, it's like I want to, there's a few different things. I would love for you to share more about what you offer and how people can get in touch with you and how they can book sessions with you or follow you or get on your list, you know, all that kind of thing, come visit you. And then I just want to reflect that everything you shared is so timely for right now, with everyone worried about immunity and the COVID and how you said it gets overlapped with these pre-existing conditions, and it's really maybe some of it's like the pre-existing conditions, right, that's actually causing it, and what is causing the asthma and the diabetes, and da-da-da. I'm just reflecting back what you said, I'm following what you said, and I've witnessed myself how, you know, I've gone off of allergy medications that I was on my whole childhood, prescription medications and stuff, once I let go of certain foods, did colon cleansing and all of that, and I think a timely message, but yet a message that you've been sharing for 20, 30, however many years, you know, 40 years, you've been sharing the same message consistently, but it's just, I think it's, you know, at the same time that there's new voices emerging, there's also the voices of ones who've been sharing the message that's, people are perking up their ears now, maybe for the first time, to really say, oh, wait a second, you know, I actually care about building my immunity or not having these pre-existing conditions that will cause me to be susceptible to X, Y, and Z. And so, yeah, your message is really timely. And I know you offer different herbs and different cleansing protocols and sessions. And
absolutely.
You know.
You know, and people will say, sister called me today, and she said, well, I went to your website, and said, well, see, that's why I haven't really tried to activate it anymore. Because my website is not able to take you into consideration.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not able to prescribe a particular combination of herbs, particularly for your concerns and your issues.
Mm-hmm.
So, no, I prefer people to talk with me. You know, and I've always offered my number at 678-760-9299 as life support. We get 24-hour, 7-day-a-week support towards undermining ourselves, eating all manners of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when at the pork shop, the barbecue place around here, they'll say the best butt in town, right? I mean, really, can you be really human and be really feasting off a pig's butt, pig's rump? You know what I'm saying? But that's the culture. We're dealing with a death culture. Without realizing, in the market yesterday, and guys all gloved up and masked up, but then he's got nothing but flesh in his heart. So we're not realizing that it's not a contagion that's in the air like that.
Mm-hmm.
And if they were really concerned about the contagion that is in the saliva. sticking something up your nose that gets to your brain to test.
Mm.
They would do it a mouth swab.
Right.
But that's like too much like right when they have another agenda and putting these nanoparticles in your brain.
Mm.
You know, so we're in a place in space where we realize that God's way is the only way when you are dealing with ones and ones. So being able to get support, be in a circle of people who care to be supported. Because what we've experienced is that once you stop doing with your family and all of them, then they start ridiculing you.
Right.
You know?
Right.
Right.
Yeah, there's so much.
Everybody goes through that. You know? What do you mean you're going to give up to me? Why do you know you want some of this chicken? Oh, you know. You know, people get ridiculed. And I'm saying, no, we create every Sunday from 3 to 7 a circle of empowerment and support. Because beyond just food, your spirit has to be nourished. Your mind has to be charged.
Right.
Your emotions, you have to really deal with the cleansing and the healing at every level.
Yes, because emotions will come out once you start to cleanse, and then you got to deal with them. You can't stuff them back down.
And so being able to be in the company of other ones who take themselves seriously enough to care to be optimally cellularly functioning.
Mm.
So we also do the ionic foot bath, detox cleanse. We also have the AO scan to help you with your tones and frequencies to create balance. I provide a wonderful vegetarian meal after our circle. So Sunday is our gathering time. The other thing is that I definitely try to be accessible, so I'm not out here trying to get tons and thousands of followers and, you know, just generating money and having my face all over the place. I'm really knowing that our charge right now, individually and collectively, and one with the other, is to be all right with walking the face of this earth as some of the most dynamic spirits to have ever lived.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's needed.
Mm-hmm.
On behalf of all of those ones through whom we've come, on behalf of all of those ones who sacrificed, on behalf of all of those ones who could not, who did not know how, who would not, we have the responsibility to set the paradigm for life culture as a result of being influenced by a death culture.
Mm.
And it's our time to rise.
Mm.
On behalf of Mother Earth, Mother Nature, all of her creatures, the establishment of the eternal government, and consciously knowing that these bodies are to be consecrated through the process of purification for the re-enthronement of the true spirits of the living gods and goddesses.
Mm.
High ethic, high morality. You understand? So you can be vegan and vegetarian and still be mean as hell, still be unforgiving. Still, you understand, still be backbiting and all of that. So now we're in a place where it's our time to realize that the virtues of character are necessary. Hitler was vegetarian. So being vegetarian does not necessarily meet the full requisite for how it is we're able to be qualified for continuance in existence when we have not been supported in understanding the laws that govern our existence.
Mm.
So there's no way to really be qualified for continuance in existence when you feel entitled to ignore, disobey, disregard the laws that govern the being. So we get a lot of that.
Thank you. your energy inspires me to make sure I'm walking in my purpose, and it's a reminder also about the importance of cleansing and not getting too sweet with all the vegan comfort foods, and to come back over to
the
real
enemas,
water rich,
right,
you know,
and doing the enemas and doing the douching and drinking the clay, and people we really
right.
know that we're discombobulated mentally and spiritually because of all of the stuff that's dwelling here with us.
Right.
So it's okay to be all right. It's okay to be cleared. It's all right to be cleansed. And it's all right to be one of the most powerful
whatever the place you see across the street and what everybody else is doing, but it's when, or in my experience, it's when I start to feel so amazing that keeps me hooked on, you know, and then I'll try to do something and it'll kind of like, no, don't do that, get back over here. So it's like getting hooked on that feeling and the symptoms going away and the diseases going away.
And the clarity of mind.
Mm-hmm.
You understand, when your cells are oppressed, it's hard to feel faith-filled.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to be confident. It's hard to be able to access the divinity of your capacity as a thinking one. You're entertaining other people's thoughts. You're not thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Most people don't know what they want.
Mm-hmm.
We were told to ask and it would be given, to knock and the door would be open, to seek and we would find. And if the extent of all that we want is to be able to pay our utilities or our bills, you understand, then we may miss ourselves. You know, so the wisdom, particularly when you're not quite sure as to what you want, what you're living for, the wisdom is to care to be fully committed to walking in the integrity of the all that you are as this living, loving, intelligent, potent, and immortal one, this absolute supreme intelligence, to clear, cleanse, purify, consecrate, be renewed, rebirth, regenerate, rejuvenate, revitalize, revivify, and to walk as a resurrected one. Liberation means that the intelligence of our being has been completely freed so that we're functioning as intelligence does, always in the best interest of ourselves, never doing things to undermine ourselves or anyone else, exalting a full effort in our living, our loving, our forgiving, our releasing, our letting go, our honoring, our exalting, our enriching, our facilitating, our supporting, our honoring, our loving, you understand, and to be a glory and an honor to the lineages that we represent, those whose names we can call and those whose names we never know. And this DNA activation that comes as a result of the cellular liberation, so that we are invoking the greatness of the ones that we are, because it's already in us. It's not virtue of our having more and more paper and money is fine. Love money, 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 money. Love it. All right, but I ain't gonna whore for it. You know what I'm saying? We're not prostitutes. We're not here. In Sam, we were told, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and all else will be added unto us.
Yes.
And heaven is the clearing, the cleansing of the temple, so that we are in alignment with the true spirit of the living God as our absolute reality, because this is the temple. They put millions and millions of dollars in polished wood, metal, and stone in all of these places to have a congregation of sick people.
Mm.
Our health, our wealth,
right,
is in our ingenuity, our talents, our creativity, our care, our love, our courage, our consistency, our freedom from inconsistency, contradiction, and hypocrisy, our high ethic and morality, our walking in the integrity of the who and the whos that we are as the children of that absolute and supreme intelligence that we refer to as God. That's what time is.
Bless your heart, sister.
Bless you. Thank you for speaking this word for us. Oh my gosh. It's like a church over here. You know, not like that, but you know, in a different way. Thank you so much, Adama. So I'm gonna have your links and things, the number and the address and all that posted. And like you said, the best way to get in touch with you is to call a number.
Or text 678-760-9299. I'm on every Thursday night, midnight to 3 at WRFG.org, by radio app, WRFG. And if you're local, 89.3 FM, Thursday nights, midnight to 3 a.m. And then you can Google or put Adama Speaks in any search engine and come across some of the online content that I have had over the last many years.
Thank you so much, Adama. It's such an honor and a blessing to have you on the show.
Thank you so much.